Hello everyone, this is Saurabh Suri. I am recently working as a system engineer in Sony Group of Corporation, Japan. I have completed my master's from IIT Bombay in electrical engineering under the specialization power systems and power electronics, and I have done my BTech from Delhi Technological University in electrical and electronics engineering. Today I'll be talking about few quick tips regarding the Japanese interviews.
Hello everyone, my name is Sana Nas and I was an MTech project research assistant in electrical engineering department. I was doing my MTech in communication engineering and I was a PRA in communication lab. I was selected for NEC last year. I was sitting for telecommunication profile and I was aiming to get in this company. So today I would be discussing few points with you all that you can just remember as a last minute prep. These will help you to leave a good impact. That's all. Nothing to take attention.
So firstly, I will be talking about the communication skills. You should keep in mind if you are talking to someone whose native language is not English, there are certain tips you can keep in mind while talking to someone. For example, in the Japanese interviews. So the very first thing is you should speak in a very confident English. Your pronunciation should be very appropriate and you should speak slowly with emphasis on each word so that the other person understands what you're trying to say. It's okay if you are taking much time to explain things, but it's not okay if you are just running with your speech and nobody is understanding anything what you're trying to say. Basically, the most questions will be around the technology. So for example, they may ask you about what projects you have done, which courses you have taken, what are your thoughts on any particular technology or any particular field which you are interested in. So there will be a lot of technical discussions. I would suggest you to keep those discussions as slow, as clear as possible so that the idea should be conveyed. There is no hustle, there is no, it's not like some train is leaving the station. You should not be in hurry. You should be very confident about every word you are saying so that the other person understands it clearly. And there can be sometimes problem understanding their accent. So before blabbering your answer, you should ask what the question is and you may ask them to repeat it multiple times. It's okay, but try to have a meaningful conversation that everyone understands.
Other than that, it is very important to understand that there is a thing called language barrier between you and the interviewer. So as soon as you start giving your interview, just greet them very politely with a smile on your face. And for the first 1 or 2 minutes, try to understand whether the person who is taking your interview is comfortable with English or not. If he is not, I recommend you to please speak in a very slow pace, use very simple English, and if you think that the person is comfortable, then you could speak in your normal pace. So during my time, fortunately, the person who was taking my interview was comfortable, so I didn't have any problem of language barrier, but I feel this could be a big issue. Because there is no point in telling all the technical information if the person who is taking your interview is not able to follow.
A question that will be asked to you, and it's a very important question, I would say. You should, before sitting in any interview, you should think about like why you want to join that company or why you want to move to Japan or like it's a survival based question, and I believe you should ask about this to yourself. I can tell you what I said during my interview. So there are multiple aspects, I believe, for a person to live life. For example, in a human life, we resort to few things like entertainment, playing sports, religion for someone, and the basic working environment or the basic family setup. So based on these 3, 4, 5 things, if you try to think about your future life in Japan, then how can you what can you say? So I answered this question of why Japan with my preferences to the cultural similarities between India and Japan. So I talked about the Japanese manga series that I like to watch. We had a small discussion on Death Note as well. I talked about how I grew up watching the Japanese anime and the cartoons like Pokemon, Shin-chan, Doraemon. I also talked about my interest in a sports called wrestling. So NJPW, New Japan Pro Wrestling, is one of the famous pay-per-views in the world. Apart from these, I also talked about my religion, that how Hinduism is very close to the one of the popular religion in Japan, which is Buddhism. I also touched upon how the Indian culture is similar to the Japanese culture in terms of the living environment. So their family, so in their family, there is a value that a guy lives with his family, which is quite different from what happens in the western part of the world. So these are few of the similarities that I don't think will be a cultural shock for me when I move to Japan. So these are certain things which are in favor, and I think I will like living in Japan. Also, when it comes to food, it's easier. It's said that it's easier for the non-vegetarians to survive in Japan, but I am so I can say I don't eat either a red meat or the white meat, so I'm pretty confident I'll survive. A friend of mine is pure vegetarian, and he's also confident he can survive. So don't worry too much about your food priorities. I think you can survive, and if food is too mainstream for you, then you may want to reconsider moving to Japan.
Be prepared with the question that I think they will ask you 95% of the times. They will surely ask you, why do you want to go to Japan and why do you think you will be able to survive there? So just spare some time before your interview and think about all these questions a little bit. Just try to show whether you are interested in their culture and in their city. I think if you are thinking of going to Japan, then you should really be interested, and it should show in your interview process.
If you can say a few words in the Japanese language during the interview, it usually brings a very bright smile on the interviewers, that I have observed personally. So you can of course learn a few words over the internet, like while greeting, you can say a few words like if I were to give an example, you can always learn these words like konnichiwa. If you want to say excuse me, then it's better to say sumimasen during the interview. How are you can be said as hajimamaste. And if you are introducing yourself, you can say watashi wa Saurabh des, means I am Saurabh. And when you are ending your conversation or ending the interview, you can greet like nice to meet you. So you can say dozo yoroshiku onegai shimasu. So these are certain things you can learn over the internet, and it's not mandatory, or it's I don't know if it matters a lot, but just to lighten up the mood, just to bring smiles on the faces, and also to say you are interested in their language as well, in their culture as well. This is a small gesture from your side you can do. It's a small extra effort you can take. Also, the Japanese firms, most of the Japanese firms are spending some time and resources into your Japanese training program, Japanese language training program. So this is one of the tip, you may say, which can help you.
Before going to the interview, just remember two words, konnichiwa and arigato gozaimasu. These mean good afternoon and thank you. I think if you say these two words during your interview, it will really help you to show that you are really interested in Japanese culture.
Now, usually when I was asking my seniors about how to approach for the Japanese interviews, those were the times when the interviews were held in offline manner, and at that time they advised me to take the printouts of the projects that you have done, not the whole projects, just the general flow, the algorithms maybe, or the flow charts in a very colorful manner with proper labeling of the results and the things that you think should value in an interview. So and again after coming and working with the Japanese guys, I have realized that the words doesn't matter much. The more power lies in what you are presenting it to them. So even if you are talking about the technology, it's okay. And I would suggest, I would appreciate if you can write some few lines or maybe few words about which you are talking about in a small slide and present it to them. Since this is an online interview, it will be much easier. You can simply ask, can I share my screen? Or they'll even ask you if you want to use the whiteboard feature. So the whiteboard feature is something which is popular in Japan. People tend to use the whiteboards to draw figures to explain what they are trying to say. Even when they are communicating with each other in their native Japanese language, they try to explain in a visual manner rather than speaking words. So I would say if you have done your projects and you think those projects are in alignment with the JAF demands, you should make a small presentation. Just a flowchart is enough. What I did was I made those flowcharts in the README file on my GitHub repository, and I shared my screen. I opened the GitHub repositories and showed them my README files, and through the README file I showed them one of the flowcharts in my projects, and that flowchart helped a lot for me to explain as well as for them to understand. So this is a simple tip which all of our seniors have been using, and I have also used it, and I would suggest you might also want to use it.
Another thing, it is important to know for which profile you are interviewing, so that you can show them during your interview process that you're really interested in that profile. Other than that, also I would suggest you all to know a little bit about the company before the interview process, because it will help you to show that you're really interested in joining their company. And I have observed that the people who are taking the interview are really eager to answer all the queries that we have regarding the company. So you can also satisfy your own queries, and in the end they generally ask, do you have any questions for us? Then you can ask on the basis of the information that you have already searched before the interview process. Many of you must have written SOPs for Japanese companies. So I would suggest all the projects that you have mentioned in your SOP, it may be your course project or your MTP thesis or your seminar, just try to get yourself comfortable with all the projects that you have mentioned, because all the technical questions that they are generally going to ask in the interview are going to be based on that. And in the end, I would just like to say that please be calm during your interview process, keep smiling, and don't be tensed. All the best for your interviews.